Thank you. Thank you. 6,000 repetitions per jump. That would do for the single. Rebound. Don't have to be the best guy in the world to be able to rebound. we had that thing down. Get that law out here, first pass, second pass, and away we go. Then all the dummy finally becomes smart. Every day we work on this practice. What do we do in the game? Rebound, game on, first pass, right there. Or right to the other. It didn't take too long to figure out why waste the time of coming out here, then that, when we can take that first pass right here and be ready to go. It saved us second in terms of being able to get down. We'll talk about some of the things that we're going to do with that way that you have to make sure you do. But that's the thing, as far as our outlet. We don't make it inside. Our outlet pass will come right here, middle, or right over here, depending upon where the ball is. We'll take it one side of the yard, right here in the middle of the board, and go from that way. We also only have one person coming to get the ball. That's the system we use. Our point guard is the guy who comes against us. We make sure we give it to him. If we don't give the ball to him, then we know our plain and simple. And I want my best ball ahead to happen. That's why I do it. So I know that may be contradictory to what not only use the side, use the side This is when it's not even happening. I go with this, you know, there's all sorts of differences. I guess the fourth part of transition is back to that word that I said at the beginning, which is the basis of the offense, and that's defense. And that's defensive tactics. We're looking for any way to get the ball from this end of the floor down there. And if we would have defense, well, the fundamental. And that's what we're working in practice. Stealing the ball. We have a drill that we run that, you know, this is something that you guys can do, and I probably have done it. We'll have something simple like this along the side. And in practice, people come up behind you looking at it. It's the foot close. It's part of your quickness. But it gets that ball free. If your man turns his back on you, there's a chance to do it. We work on double teaming. And when we get that ball loose, then we go. Okay? While we're talking about the first part of maybe getting the ball, now we're in the fast break. And I think I said some things about that already. But really, when we get the fast break, going down, two things are going to happen. Number one, maybe an individual comes right first. If he gets the ball, we either pass it to him or we make the steal and he goes down. How many times have you seen somebody come out of the way, right down the middle, and it stands next to me and go, pull it off? Well, I've seen it a lot. In fact, 4 years ago, that kind of maneuver cost us the Section 4 championship. So what we try to teach you, you're going to have a fast break or any layup situation, lay the ball off. Your chance of making it is so much greater. Don't take the extent, it's lay up for the next thing. That's the breakaway. Other situations, you may be a 2-on-1, down 2. I spent some time in the spring talking with some kids who come back from my college club. We had fooled around with something last year. I don't know, but I wanted to see what they felt like. A lot of times, when you've got a great situation going, 3-on-2 situation coming down the floor. We hit the ball right here. Since you can't take the ball in, you can't penetrate it anymore quick. You move the ball back around, you still can't penetrate it. Did your fast break come out? No.
learned how to do this year, I think it's one of the best things we've ever done. If we fly, we run our fast break this way, if we come on the stop, forget the lake. From right to here, to stop, what will the young child?
Thank you. Have that fall. What
set off that instead of once you get down in a 5-5 situation with both of them. But here's the problem, 50% of the time, it was our transition game that really came to me. That's what we had to learn. Now, I know whether very good points, just, I guess maybe minor things to do. Getting back into the working right there. told you we went, our community looked at the sign. We always look at the middle. The key, as far as I'm concerned, is looking at the middle. And what this sign does is right here. And this sign does not stand here. He comes and stands here and waits for the wall. Chances are it's right back up there. You see a pass coming to you, you step to it. Step to get the ball, and as you come to it, you both be down at the same time, so you go to the other one. This way, square yourself up. Never start doing this. Really square. Get it right here. Look to see where everybody is, and then start to pull. Both feet come meet the ball, square as you're going back, you go on. And I guess while I'm saying you're receiving the ball, it's the other thing too. Anytime you receive the ball, particularly when you're not considered the basket in the court, you should be in what we call a triple threat position. Turn to vertical. Triple threat position is what? What can you do? Pass, shoot, or drop. Now you've got your defense again, right? You want to do that. And if you have both of your feet set, so either one can be used as pivot foot, and you square yourself right up, here, we're pulling you a lot, you can shoot, or you can take your time. You're all set. So you receive a ball, always receive in triple threat position. So, see what you can do, you're out here by yourself, take it off the wall. Bounce the pass off the wall, go to me, make sure you come down. Little things should work. Okay, movement. Basketball is key to find movement. People stand around. A lot of times you hear about movement. Get some movement. Go to meet the ball. Pass it straight away. But you've got to be moving that. Right? I don't know if an offense rule is a base point sometimes. That's something you've got to make. The last point, and I guess it's the committee, the most important. And I think that you guys are taking the next step. Playing the Christmas tournament is not in the final. building. And the teams of one. And that looks so important. Have to have it. Has to be here. Number thank you.
dogs. I'm going under the rainbow. Just one more time.
Seven Central. Tomorrow on Good Morning America, Arthur Miller takes a look at this.
It's interesting to consider the difference in mood of New Year's Eve, you know, that we're approaching now, and 40 years ago when people had no idea what was in store. Just in that next year, you know, that was momentous and largely good. The war ended. For me, I can remember that I had no idea, of course, but three things that happened that were important to me, and one was I did my first television program.
Oh, people. That's in the history books. Oh, I mean, everybody remembers that, yes.
Sure.
We just couldn't squeeze
them. They were all tuned in, yeah. Right.
And my son, did your first television program
in 1945. It was experimental in Chicago, and I did. And my son was to be born that year,
H-O.
45, right? And Arthur Clark worked out the orbital mechanics for the communications satellite. And look what that started.
You're one of the few people who would remember the date of that.
Well, I was into then. What I know you were very little, but
I was in school then in Florida at that time, and I don't remember too much. I don't remember anything.
Probably not celebrating
dramatic that year.
Yeah. Well, that brings us to the end of a year, actually, and we have a word right now about tonight's Nightline.
Tonight, Afghanistan, 5 years after the Soviet invasion. How has the United States responded? Can Afghanistan free itself from Soviet domination? Among Nightline's guests tonight, Afghanistan's UN ambassador and a supporter of the Afghanistan resistance movement.
That's on Nightline, following your local news. And that is 2020 for tonight. We are in touch, so you be in touch. I'm Hugh Downs.
And I'm Barbara Walters, and we both wish everybody a
happy new year and a healthy new year.
And to you.
Thank you, and to you, Barbara. Good night to all.
Tomorrow on Good Morning America, Arthur Miller takes a look at the Supreme Court, also a preview of the Gator Bowl, and exercise advice from the experts on Good Morning America. Saturday following T.J. Hooker, the best-made plans for romance go overboard when a love potion backfires for Don Adams and Audrey Meadows on Love Boat. Then a look at the Supreme Court of the United States on ABC News Close-Up. Later tonight, fitness programs for senior citizens on Eye on Hollywood.
transcript of tonight's broadcast, send $3 to Journal Graphics, Box 2020, Ansonia Station, New York, New York, 10023. This has been the ABC News Magazine, 2020.
National Powers Tangle in postseason play. Tomorrow night, number 7, South Carolina battles 9th-ranked Oklahoma State in the Gator Bowl.